Well, tonight it's my tribute to the late Gene Krupa, which concentrates in the main, though not exclusively, on his work with small bands. Thousands of drummers the world over have been influenced by him, and he himself was one of the first jazz drummers to have learned percussion from the book. Despite all that, there remains something quite distinctive about drumming like this. Gene Krupa's Sextet of 1953, playing a composition by Charlie Shavers called Whose Rhythm? Shavers on trumpet, Eddie Lockjaw Davis on tenor, Bill Harris on trombone, Teddy Wilson on piano, Ray Brown on bass. The arrangement was by Charlie Shavers and very reminiscent of the sort of things that he used to arrange for the old John Kirby band.
The government newspaper Izvestia claimed that Peking had welcomed the outbreak of fighting in the Middle East and had tried to increase tension between Russia and America with, if possible, even a direct military clash. At home again, the entire staff at the Claycross Urban Council in Derbyshire have gone on strike. The 30 members of the local government officers' union, including senior officers and typists, walked out in support of the council's four chief officials who resigned last week. The officials had refused to obey instructions from the council to award pay increases to manual workers above the limit imposed by the government. For the newsroom, that's all for the moment. The next summary at 9 o'clock.
Radio 2, 1500, 247 and VHF. It's 2 minutes past eight.
Hello again, Humphrey Littleton here with the best part of an hour of jazz between now and 9 o'clock. This week, another mixture of old and new, starting with another look at the album. Sorry, I've just drunk some BBC coffee with a bit of sugar in it, and it's stuck in my throat, and I might never not be able to speak another word in the next hour, but we've got plenty of music to fill in if that happens. Now, we're going to have another look now at the album just released on the VJM label called Spania in Chicago. This was the band recorded in 1954 with Earl Hines on piano, Muggsy Spanier on cornet, Darnell Howard on clarinet, Jimmy Archie on trombone, Pops Foster bass, and I think Earl Watkins on drum, so it doesn't specify him in the on the sleeve. This band had a quite unique and punchy sound, and it was exaggerated somewhat on the recordings, not only this one, but another recording under Earl Hines' name, which came out some time ago, by a very toppy sort of sound, which gives it quite a, as I say, quite a unique sound, which is applied now to the Spencer Williams classic Mahogany Hall Stomp. We'll be right back.
and the unmistakable sound of Earl Hines showing his approval at the end of that version of Mahogany Hall Stomp, which is on the LP Spanier in Chicago on the VJM label, VJM LC2. Do take that down, because I know there'll be a lot of people who write to me asking where they can get that one. You can get that now, VJM LC2. You remember last week I looked at a new LP called The Explosive Sounds of the Big Band, on which I played, from which I played a Jerry Mulligan track, Little Rock Getaway. And in order to find out the complete personnel, I looked up the original LP by that band, which was Jerry Mulligan's concert jazz band from 1962-63. I thought, while I've got the LP out, I'll play another track from it. And this one's a slow one. It's an arrangement, in fact, a composition by Jerry Mulligan. It features Mulligan doing what seems on paper to be the impossible, which is to make the baritone sax sound in places like a clarinet. And there's also some fine trombone from Bob Brookmeyer. The title of it, Ballad.
Thank you.
fine writing for the Jerry Mulligan 14-piece band there, a composition by Jerry Mulligan called Ballad. That was the band of 62-63, Jerry Mulligan's concert jazz band. I did a slight injustice last week to a new Jimmy Witherspoon LP on the RCA black and white label, the import label, because I said that it had some not very impressive versions of popular songs. In point of fact, I was reading the sleeve, and I was reading from the complete recent discography of Jimmy Witherspoon, and not, in fact, but it's on this particular issue. I stand by what I said about the first side, which is that it has a lot of rather rock and roll-y tracks with a slightly distressing vocal group in the background. But on the second side, I remember I played one of three old Jay McShann classics, Jumping the Blues, Hootie Blues, and Confessing the Blues. But there are some more fine blues things on that, so I thought to put the record right, I'd play another track by Jimmy Witherspoon. And this one features some of the backing musicians: Ray Copeland's on trumpet, J.C. Higginbottom on trombone, Hilton Jefferson on alto, Selden Powell on tenor, Haywood Henry on baritone, Jay McShann, of course, leading on piano, Kenny Burrell on guitar, Gene Ramey on bass, and Marcy Alexander on drums. And Jimmy Witherspoon is in right from the off on this one. It's called Blue Monday Blues.
My mind just ain't right. Going back to Kansas City, I'm leaving tonight. Going back to Kansas City. Going back to Kansas City. Going back to Kansas City, where to swing the blues all night. I was first on Main, then I was on Beale, looking for my girl that they call Lucille. So going back to Kansas City. Going back to Kansas City. Going back to Kansas City, where they play the blues all night. Got me a big bulldog. Yes, and a couple of greyhounds. Yes, I got me a big bulldog. Couple of greyhounds. I got to find my baby. They said she's Kansas City bound.
Jimmy Witherspoon with Jay McShann's band back in 1957 singing Blue Monday Blues, and that's on RCA 741083. 741083. You have to order that one because it's an import, unless your shop happens to have them right there. But you can get that one, and there's some good stuff on it. I get so fed up with having to tell people that records that I play on this program are no longer available, or are deleted, and not in the catalogues, that it's... I'm particularly happy about a coincidence that happened last week. I was opening my mail. The first letter I opened was from a listener who asked if there were any of the old Bob Crosby recordings, especially the Bobcats recordings, on LP available at the moment. And the second thing I opened was a parcel of records with a new album by Bob Crosby and his orchestra and the Bobcats. And it also says on this that it's volume two. Volume one hasn't come my way yet, but it means that there are quite a lot coming out now of these old reissues from the great Bob Crosby Orchestra of the late 30s. I'm going to, in fact, play two tracks from this LP, one by the big band and one by the Bobcats, which will be later on. The big band one that I've chosen because it features in the opening bars the clarinet of Irving Fazola, who was, of course, one of the jewels in that Bob Crosby band of 1938. The full lineup is Charlie Spivak, Yank Lawson, Billy Butterfield on trumpets, Ward Silloway and Warren Smith on trombone, Fazola on clarinet, Matty Matlock on clarinet and alto, Joe Cairns on alto, Eddie Miller on clarinet and tenor, Gil Rodin on tenor, Bob Zirke on piano, Naffy Lamar on guitar and singing the vocal here, Bob Haggart bass, Ray Baduke on drums, and of course Bing's younger brother Bob doing nothing much except giving the illustrious Crosby name to the organization, and in fact it was that name that really launched this band, which started as a cooperative band. Let's hear them now playing the Milk Cow Blues.
By the way she lows, Lord, if you see my milk cow buddy, I said, please drive her home. Says I ain't had no milk and butter from you, Lord, since my cow's been gone.
Bob Crosby Orchestra back in 1938 playing Milk Cow Blues. That one's on Coral CP110, Coral CP110. And some of the other big band tracks that are on that, the Yancey Special, Big Noise from Winnetka, which is a bit of an exaggeration to call that a big band track, but that should sell quite a few copies on its own. And the very fine gospel-inspired composition by Bob Haggard called I'm Praying Humble. I'll come back to that LP later on in the program. Meanwhile, let's turn to some early Buddy Rich. When I say early, I'm not going back right to the 30s when he was a big band drummer, but to the early 50s when he made some small band recordings, which have just been issued on a Verve double album. Quite a selection of all stars on these tracks. Harry Edison's on all of them, or most of them on trumpet. Otherwise, there's people like Benny Carter, Georgie Orr, Flip Phillips, and so on. The track that I've chosen was recorded in 1955, November the 10th, 1955, very nearly, well, however many years ago it is. I can't subtract, I don't know about that. This has got Harry Edison on trumpet, Sonny Chris on alto, Jimmy Rolls on piano, John Simmons on bass, and of course Buddy Rich on drums. And it's a little blues theme called Sunny and Sweet.
Bye.
A track there featuring Sonny Chris on alto, Harry Sweets Edison on trumpet, among others, and it was called Sonny and Sweets. That's by the Buddy Rich Quintet. It's on a double album of Buddy Rich small groups recorded back in the early 50s. Incidentally, I just fed, while that was going on, fed the information I gave you before into the computer, and it's come up with the answer that that was recorded 18 years ago, very nearly to the day. A double album on Verve 2683035. Well, a few years, 3 years, in fact, before that was recorded, I'm really putting myself through tonight, 3 years before that was recorded, in 1952, this is, the Count Basie Orchestra was just coming back, the Count Basie Big Band was just coming back. There'd been a hiatus, which looms very large in the all the biographies of Count Basie, although, in fact, it only occupied a matter of months more than, rather than years, during which he gave up his big band. And then in the early 50s, he started up again. And it's an interesting big band, this one. It has many of the new names, which became household names in what's generally known as the new Count Basie Band. People like Joe Newman and Marshall Royal and Gus Johnson, in fact, is the drummer here, who was the drummer of the Basie Band at that time. And I've got a track here, which is interesting, too, because it's one of the first appearances with the Basie Band of a man who... on and off has been with the band ever since right up to this present day. And that's Eddie Lockjaw Davis, who's down in the personnel here simply as Eddie Davis. He hadn't acquired his nickname by that time. And this is a fine track, which is sort of halfway between the old Count Basie riff band of the late 30s and the powerhouse and precision big band that we all know today. This is a thing called Bread. From an album called The Second Big Band Sound of Count Basie, Count Basie and his orchestra, recorded back in the early 50s, 52 to be exact, and that featured Joe Newman on music trumpet, Eddie Davis on tenor sax, and that's just been issued on Verve 2317074, Verve 2317074. Remember last week I played a track from the Get Happy Band on a new BJM album. And I mentioned that as well as having some tracks by the Blue Ribbon Syncopators, it also had one side devoted to the great Sam Morgan jazz band of New Orleans, which recorded back in 1927. I thought it was rather silly to go on talking about the great Sam Morgan band without in fact playing a track from them. So I've got one that's coming up right now. Sam Morgan, in fact, had suffered earlier, before these recordings were made, a series of strokes, which made his made him not exactly retire from trumpet playing, but certainly take a back seat, and his brother, Isaiah Morgan, took most of the lead trumpet and solo parts. But in fact, at the end of this recording, we do hear a little bit of Sam Morgan on muted trumpet taking a break, and we also hear him singing, and if you listen very carefully, I think you can hear what sounds like a kind of rhythmic click in the recording, which comes from the slapstick, the the origin of the word, the instrument that makes a kind of slapping noise, and you can hear him when he sings the vocal slapping away regardless in the background. This is, to my mind, one of the most underrated of all the old New Orleans bands. Beautiful loping rhythm, and the whole thing absolutely relaxed with anything. Here's their version of Everybody's Talking About Sammy. Morgan's jazz band there, recorded back in 1927 with Sam Morgan himself singing and playing the trumpet break at the end, also playing slapstick all the way through, and that was Everybody's Talking About Sammy. And the other members of the band, Sam Morgan and Isaiah on the cornets, Ike Morgan on clarinet, Jim Robinson on trombone, Andrew Morgan on clarinet and tenor, Earl Fouché on soprano and alto, Walter Deku on piano, Johnny Davis on banjo, Jim Little on string bass, and William Nolan on drums, one of the great bands, as I say. And that's available now on VJM label VLP 32, and there are 8 tracks by that Sam Morgan band on one side of that LP. Right, well, now here's an old one that is, as far as I know, unavailable at the moment. It's a deleted recording made some time back, and it brought together Duke Ellington and John Coltrane. It also brought together John Coltrane and a tune written originally for Johnny Hodges by Billy Strayhorn. You may think that it's likely to be a strange interpretation, a Johnny Hodges piece interpreted by John Coltrane, but this is some absolutely beautiful tenor saxophone playing. Sam Woodyard and Aaron Bell are on drums and bass, respectively, and then there's Duke and Coltrane playing My Little Brown Book.
Thank you.
Duke Ellington and John Coltrane playing Billy Strayhorn's composition, My Little Brown Book. Now, back to that Bob Crosby album, which in fact is called Come On and Hear, Volume 2. And I'm going to play one now by the Bobcats. Some of the other tracks by the Bobcats are the Honky Tonk Train Blues, the Jazz Me Blues, All By Myself, and one or two other tracks too by them. But I've chosen one now, which is a blues by the original Dixieland Jazz Band, or two members thereof. In fact, the ODJB wasn't a blues band, and you find that all of the blues that they recorded were in fact simply 12-bar themes with a fairly jaunty sort of approach. So don't sit back expecting a kind of relaxed and late night blues coming up now, because you'll be jolted out of your seat. The lineup on this one is Billy Butterfield on trumpet, Warren Smith trombone, Eddie Miller on tenor, Irving Fazola clarinet, Bob Zirke on piano, Nappy Lamar on guitar, Bob Haggart bass, and Ray Baduc on drums. And this one's the Morning Blues. Bob Crosby's Bobcats with Morning Blues. That's morning as in ashes to ashes and dust to dust. Probably the most inappropriate title for a jaunty tune like that. It was written by J. Russell Robinson and Tony Sparborough, the ODJB. And let me remind you that the Bobcats version is newly reissued on Coral CP110. Now, back to 1947 with a little track here by Coleman Hawkins, who at that time was playing host to many of the younger bebop musicians. And in fact, this one features in solo, apart from Hawkins, Fats Navarro on trumpet, J.J. Johnson on trombone. It's called Half Step Down, Please. Thank you. Coleman Hawkins Band of 1947 with Half Step Down, please. Well, last week I played a track from a new LP recorded at the Montreux Jazz Festival, and it featured Bill Coleman on flugelhorn. In fact, the group that Bill Coleman was appearing with also had Guy Lafitte, a very fine French tenor saxist. So I thought it'd be nice this week to end with one of the tracks featuring Lafitte as well as Bill Coleman. It's an international band, Jack Suing, the bass players from Holland, otherwise Mark Hemmeler on piano and Daniel Hume on drums, are both Swiss musicians. I'll give you the number now. It's Black Lion 2460212. 2460212. Might not get a chance later. Here's Bill Coleman's group from the album Mainstream at Montreux playing Blue Lou. Bill Coleman and Guy Lafitte at Montreux, and it's almost incredible hearing that agile trumpet to believe that Bill Coleman is coming up to 70 years of age. Anyway, after the news, we shall have big band sounds from Allendale. I shall be back again with more jazz of all ages this time next week. Until then, this is Humphrey Littleton saying goodbye now.
And this is the part of the Monday night I always enjoy. Not my cup of tea, but Allendale's big band sound.
What a nice introduction. Thank you very much, Tom. Welcome to all of you. I think the program is a bit on the nostalgic side this evening. Anyway, join us and find out. Right, off we go. A little bit later, we're going to be taking a look at a set of Harry Roy reissues, so I thought we ought to keep the first segment somewhat in character. So here is our big band, Dancing Time. Neil Hefti wrote in 1955 of Cole Porter's You Do Something to Me for his own orchestra, but there it was remembered by Billy May, and that's one of the tracks on a Time Life set that has yet to be released. It'll be out in 1974, so there's still more good things to look forward to. And still in the dancing mood, a track from that John Scott Trotter album of Memories of the Hal Kemp Band, which we reviewed some time back. Here's East of the Sun.
Thank you. We'll build a dream house of love, dear, near to the sun in the day, near to the moon at night. We'll live in a lovely way, dear, living on love and moonlight, just you and I forever and a day. Up among the stars we'll find a harmony of life to a lovely tune. East of the sun and west of the moon, dear. East of the sun and west of the moon.
Group remembering the Hal Kemp style of the 30s. Here's a switch. The latter-day Casaloma Orchestra, in the style of their own famous theme, Smoke Rings, play Fly Me to the Moon. Joe Howard on trombone, Abe Most on clarinet.